What's going on, fight fans and friends? It's your boy, Tavon Anthony. And, dude, every time I think the UFC will just stop dropping bombs, they drop even more. Dude, we have two amazing fights that have been announced. We have Pedro Munhoz versus Dominick Cruz for UFC 269. This is going to be freaking bananas. And we have Islam Makhachev versus the stepping in man, the man with the plan, Dan Hooker, Hangman. Dude, it's going to be freaking bananas. Let's check this out, man. So, Dominick Cruz. Pedro Munhoz, like Dominick at 36 years old, Pedro at 35. I always think Pedro's younger, but I have that problem with specific fighters that have been around for a while, but I just always do that. But dude, early prediction, I think Dominick Cruz is going to outpoint him. I think he's going to outpoint him. I think he's going to think unless Pedro comes in and uses that thick lower half of himself and just and slams them legs and just keeps Dominick from moving. But, I mean, that's way easier said than done. It's way easier said than done. But if he can stop him from moving, I think he can clip him. But I think Dominick is just going to – I think he's just going to outseason the man, you know. I think he's going to do what he does best and come up with a unanimous decision. Next – at UFC 267, Dan Hangman Hooker. This man is like just game at all times, man. He's game at all times. And I'm just like so excited for this because to step in against a dude that a lot of people are just trying to avoid, right? And then also, like, just being honest, I believe like Islam, I thought he was going to do RDA worse than Habib did. I really did. Now you can't complain. You cannot complain. I'm going to look you guys dead in the eye. You can't complain. Any Islam hater cannot complain. Okay? This is a fight. Okay? Dan's going to come to fight, and you can't complain. There's going to be no room for saying, like, oh, he had an easy night out. And even if it looks easy, I'm not saying it is. Like, granted, that Dagestani wrestling is something else, and that strength is a whole nother factor. But, you know, there's no way there's no excuse this time. He has a legit guy that's only lost to the elite. Dan has only lost to the elite. So when you're looking at this fight, it's just like, what is there to complain about? Amazing. I don't believe that Islam is going to make the mistakes of a normal wrestler and just come in with a lazy takedown and get up-kneed by Dan Hooker. But I do believe Dan's going to bring that fight. You know, he's got the height and reach advantage. He's going to come in. He's going to swing for them fences. He's going to put it on him. He's going to put it on Islam, like, any way he can. So I think it's going to be a great fight. I think it's going to be a great fight. I could see Islam taking this by decision. I don't really see him finishing Dan unless it's some, like, submission through, like, sheer exhaustion or something like that. That's what I see. But it's a wonderful, wonderful fight, dude. It's a wonderful fight. I am so happy to be alive as a fight fan, like, in this day and age. Like, this is amazing. Man, the UFC just keeps dropping bombs. So, yeah, man. Tell me what you guys think, and tell me who you got. I can't wait. Dude, I'm doing a blue corner, red corner rap for this fight specifically. I normally do those for, like, fights that are, like, main events and whatnot, but no, this is the truth right here. I'm definitely going to just single out that fight and just go in. I love them both. I love them both. But I think Dan, he can surprise someone. He can surprise us. But safe bet, Islam. And I'm just going to say this right now. I'm going to need everyone to stop looking at Islam. Like, you know, some people online looking at Islam strictly as Habib's successor or Habib 2.0, this, that, and the other. No, he is the first Islam Makhachev, period. That is who he is. All right. He's going to come in. He does his thing. Like, I love it. I love it. I love it. I love the wrestling. I love his awareness. And, you know, he's getting better as he moves up. He's getting better as he moves up. And he's proving that, you know, it might seem like he's walking in the footsteps of Habib. It might seem that way. But I think he can do more work. I think he can do more work than Habib did. Until, you know, ultimately somebody just comes and they, you know, figure out that entire game plan. But it's going to be a while. It's going to be a while. But either way, look, like, subscribe, tell me what you guys think. And, yeah, it's going to be a great fight.